Well, as you can tell, I'm not in a tree stand this morning. I got up with full intentions of going and climbing in my climber across the river. But when I walked outside, it was 24 degrees and we have a pretty good frost. So I figured it's probably not a good idea to go down there and climb a climber with ice on it. But anyway, since I had my Spartan GoCam out here on this little woodlot, I know that there's deer coming through because it's been sending the pictures to my phone. About mid-morning, there should be a group of nannies coming through here, and that's what I need. I've already used both my buck tags this year, so it's time to put meat in the freezer, and I need to look for them does. You know me, I'm an archer. I don't use guns, and if I'm in the woods and I'm hunting, I've got a Magnus Broadhead strapped to my daggone arrow. This particular head is a Black Hornet's razor. This is my new go-to. Past two seasons I've been using these and they are devastating. I mean, blood trails are great. They drop deer quick. I hunt subdivision, so that's a must-have. I got one place that I hunt that's 30 yards wide by 100 yards long is the land, the woods that I have to hunt that is mine. So if you're going to shoot them, they got to drop quick, and these things really do it. Now, there's nothing wrong with the other Magnus heads. People kill a lot of things with them, and I've killed everything under the sun with the buzz cut. Matter of fact, I got a buzz cut with me today. I keep one in my quiver. They're great heads. They're very accurate, fly true, and they do the damage too. I've had some serious luck with these little things, and so I'm gonna use these as my main head from now on. We're gonna sit back and wait, let it warm up a little bit, I hope, because it is pretty chilly, and see if as the woods wake up that those don't come out here in this little opening and give me a shot. Stay tuned, and we'll see what we can harvest today. I'm gonna go ahead and knock this thing up so I'll be ready. Gotta show you a little something real quick. I've wanted one of these for about 2 years now, and I finally got one this year. I don't do a whole lot of blind hunting, but when I do, it's really nice to have something like this. Usually I lay my bow across my lap or lay it on the ground. I've had the hook that you hang it, but the bow swings, gets in the way. I don't really like it, so I ended up getting a Magnus bow pod. Look at that bow. It's just standing there. I reach right here and I pick it up, dude. It's awesome. The arrow doesn't get stuck on the ground with leaves and stuff on it. I mean, I don't have to worry about my release tapping my bow while it's in my lap. This thing is amazing. I'm quick to set up, put on your bow. Whenever you get ready to go, you can unscrew the two legs. They screw together and they fit right in your quiver, just like an arrow does. So you just leave it on all the time. When you're going to blind hunt, you screw the legs in. It's an ingenious, I mean, awesome, awesome tool to have with me. Now, let's get this back. If I can just get a doe to come out here, we'll get some footage of a shot and follow up, and hopefully get some of you boys shooting these daggone Magnus broadheads, because I'm telling you, if you're not, you're missing out. Stay tuned. Let's see what happens. Alright, well, I had a doe and a buttonhead come in, and I thought I had a nice good shot on the doe. I took it about 31 yards. I took it, and as soon as the arrow hit, I knew something wasn't right because it didn't go through. I don't know how much penetration I got, but apparently I hit the shoulder. So I guess this will be where we prove whether or not these black hornets or razors are durable broadheads or not. I have faith in my broadheads, like I hope most of y'all do with the broadheads you use. She took off running down the hill there, and I heard some crashing, but I'm not sure if it was her crashing or just both of them running through the leaves. It sounded like it was in one general area, like it wasn't moving, so maybe I got through the shoulder and into the lungs. I hope so anyway. Kind of a little depressed right now because I haven't lost a deer in I don't know how long. But like I said, I got faith in my broadheads, and we'll see what happens. So all my fault. I mean, I tried to put it down there and get a heart because she was quartering away a little bit, and I guess I pulled or jerked or something. I hit a little higher than I was aiming. I don't think nope, there's a rod right here, and I'm making sure I didn't hit it. Fletchings may have caught it, may have kicked it up, but I don't think so. But anyway, well, even though I heard the crash and stuff, I'm gonna probably give it about 20 or 30 minutes, and I'll get out, and I'll go right over the little hill right here and see. Hopefully, I'll be able to tell soon as I get over that hill if we got a good hit or not. But stay tuned. I'll get some video of whatever I got. Hopefully, it'll be a blood trail ending in a dead doe because she was a nice-sized nanny. But stay tuned. Let's see if this works out. I hope it does. Be another way to prove these broadheads are mean. So I'll get with you when I get on the blood trail. Stay tuned. All right, I just shot that doe. I don't know, 30 minutes ago. And of course I thought I had a bad shot. Didn't get much penetration, but I mean, there's the blind. I'm 30 yards from it, and already got definitely that blood trail. I mean, and it's flipping awesome. Even a bad shot. So I'm gonna walk right down here where I heard the crashing, and hopefully she's there. If not, I'll back out and come back and look in a little while. If you bow hunt long enough, you'll make shots like this. But anyway, I got faith. We'll go see if she's right over this hill right over here. I'll get back with you. Oof. All right. I made what I consider to be a bad shot on a deer. I didn't get a pass through, so I had to hit her in the shoulder. But she left a hell of a blood trail to follow. I heard the crashing. I Google mapped it from here to the blind is 322 feet. She was 30 yards away. That's 107 yards, 3 yards away. So she went 77 yards with a bad shot. We're gonna flip it over. See, ooh, nice, nice, nice. Now, broadhead's still in there, so I got to be really careful. She's gonna slide down the hill on me. Really careful, but that's a nasty hole. Yeah. right in the scapula. That may be a good one to clean. I'm wondering if it's stuck in there or if it went all the way through. But we only got a hole on one side. I got the blood trail videoed up through there. I'll post it at the end because some people don't like to watch that. But even with a flipping what I consider a bad shot, being a non-pass through in the shoulder, this deer went, well, I say 77 yards, I think. And blood trail was from the time it started until now, and it was steady the whole way. I've shot with mechanicals, and I've shot other fixed blades, and even with a good double lung shot on those with them other heads, I never had the blood trail like this. I don't know if it's the serrazer edge of these, because I haven't tried the straight edge, but I know my buzz cuts, when I used them, they were serrated, and they gave decent blood trails. They were comparable to most of the broadheads I shot, but these black hornets, man, they're, holy cow, a whole nother level of blood trails on them. For those of you who need the blood trail to follow, I suggest a look into these. I used my Spartan GoCams, another tool that I've used that this year has changed the whole way I hunt. They send the pictures to me. I had decided to go hunting across the river over there this morning, and when I got up and realized that it was frost, and I don't really like climbing in metal stands when there's frost on them, I said, well, what can I do now? I mean, I got the blind, but is there anything coming by there? And, you know, what time would it be? Well, I mean, I know I've been getting pictures from over there, but I was able to pull up the pictures that I've had, and I was able to look at them and tell exactly when the deer were coming through. So I knew that this deer and the one with it was coming through, and there's actually two or three more groups of them that come through. While I was walking off the hill towards this one, I heard a deer blow. Of course, I got that sinking sensation that it was this deer that I had made a bad shot on. I know I'd heard some crashing, but I thought maybe it was just the leaves sliding or whatever after I'd shot. But ended up, I followed the blood trail, and it wasn't her, because I don't believe she'd have blowed like this. But we're going to take this deer. We're going to get the four-wheeler. It's a nice hill right here, and there's a logging trail right there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pull it right off the logging trail, pull the four-wheeler around, and pull the four-wheeler around, load her on it, take her to the dang house. Looks like hops are nasty, so I guess they're starting their second rut this year. But anyway, we'll get some inside pictures and we'll see what kind of carnage that thing did. I'm actually wondering myself what it did, if it stuck in the shoulder, if it stuck in the other shoulder, if it's just bouncing around inside the body or what. But we'll find out here shortly. Just stay tuned, and I'll put some more of the video together. But anyway, if you're looking for a broadhead, I mean, black hornets or razors, that's the way to go. Oh, or if you're hunting turkeys, bullhead. Stay tuned. Let's see what else happens. Okay, here's the lungs. You can see right here, nice hole on one lung. The other one, it just shredded one end of it. So basically a single lung shot, and it still only went that far. Now these lungs, I actually filled them full of water so that they would clean out, and that's why they're so freaking big. But you can see it's just coming out. But like I said, there's one lung, and the other lung, it's got the front of and just chewed it up right here. All right. In the cavity, you can actually see where it caught the backbone. I guess that's what actually caught it, but it did penetrate through. This was the onside, and this is the offside. So it went all the way through. Got into the backbone a little bit. That's probably where a lot of the blood came from, that artery that runs down through there and then out on that side.
Didn't get anything over here though. So it's, I can, let's see. I don't know. I gotta find my broadhead somewhere, but I'm assuming it's in this leg right here, but it may be down there in the bucket. Well, after cutting the deer up and finding that the broadhead had went through one scapula and then caught the hard part of the other scapula, the actual shoulder, took out part of the backbone. Well, I cut into the scapula on the offside, thinking that my broadhead was stuck in there. Well, once I got it done, I realized it wasn't stuck in there. So when I come to get rid of the carcass, I decided to check where the deer had died and done its little death struggle, and I found my broadhead. And you know what? It's none the worse for wear. That was four deer. Of course, I'm on the end of the arrow, but that's four. I'm gonna go for number five with it. This is that man to be lodged in the daggum shoulder and come all the way down this hill, 70, what, four, whatever yards it was. And it still ain't broke. Bleeder blades are all right. I mean, come on. I'm a believer. You should be. Okay. I just clocked it on Google Maps. She went 70 yards. Here she is. Nice fat nanny. Blood trail. I can't believe it, dude. I got, well, here, I'll show you. There's the penetration I got. Right there. So I got into the lungs. Went through the scapula, I'm assuming. Maybe stuck in the other side. We'll see when we cut her open. But I just want to show you again, even with the bad shot that I made, looking at, yeah, okay, so someone may say, well, that's right where the deer's at. It was like this the whole way, all 70 damn yards.
Blowing it everywhere.
I think the camera cut off. It only recorded so much, but anyway, I said there's a blind right there. But I mean, the blood trail. They're letting me come away from it. I'm just trying to to as close as I could get so that you could see what it actually was. 70 yards. Anyway. But I'm gonna get the camera. There's the blind where I shot her from. And she started bleeding nearly immediately. Here's just a few specks where she come through. And if I remember correctly, there's right where she jumped through the bushes. Anyway, there's the blind. I'm gonna grab the camera, go down there and do a little more video. Stay tuned.